It's January 16th, and this is an update. And we've seen another part of the copy of the phone call conversation in the jailhouse between Caylee and her parents. Now, at this point, we don't want to tell Caylee. I mean, she thinks that she's getting all the support from in the mail, you know, whereas Cindy and George talk about hate mail. She's getting all this positive stuff. Well, what we need to keep secret from Caylee is that those so-called well-wishing letters that she's getting that praise her and et cetera, et cetera, are nothing more than souvenir hunters. They want Caylee to write back. And so then they will either have a letter or a signature of hers that they can sell on eBay. Yes, yes, yes. Collecting criminal memorabilia is really big bucks. And I checked eBay, and already they're selling the copies of the People magazine, the issue that had a fairly large spread on this case. But anyway, we'll just keep that between ourselves. I've got a link for the full interview, and I suggest that you listen to that in its entirety without the hysteria. You know, you can't get anywhere by being, swayed by all sorts of stuff like that. I want to say here, so far, Kathy Bellick is the reporter, is the one that I feel who is consistently doing a good job. If anybody knows her, you might pass that on to her. Thanks for the good work. Essentially, what this interview tonight has been is essentially more of the same. What I was trying to say in my previous video with the interview with Lee, that when Caylee suddenly had a wake-up call that she was not going to be able to manipulate her way out of this situation. When he confronted her, you know, the police are going to come in and they're going to say, "Hello, Miss Anthony, where's your baby? Or where's your child?" And you say, "She's with the nanny and she's asleep, so we don't want to disturb." "Fine, Miss Anthony, get in the car. We're going to go and we'll go get Caylee and everybody will be happy." Well, when he said that, of course, this shocked her. The whole situation was revealed to her, the absurdity of her position. Now, we race ahead to this this theatrics on this video tonight. And we have more of the same, though we do get a very good look at the sociopath's method of manipulation. They stick with the people they can manipulate, and they avoid the ones that see through them. This is consistent throughout. Let's see here. So anyway, you see the manipulation going on. Cindy, naturally enough, says, "Okay, now you've said that she was kidnapped. Now we're checking on your story. Now where do we go next?" A reasonable position, a reasonable question, and coming from an unreasonable person. But nevertheless, Caylee throws she stamps her little foot and says, "Oh, you don't know what I'm going through." Okay. I mean, I don't need to belabor that. But we see the method, and she has successfully switched the conversation, switched the focus from her, where it belongs, to the parents, to Caylee. And all along, you know, the father says, okay, now you're the boss here, and she gets upset at that. She has been the boss throughout the Anthony side of things. She has been the boss. She has told them and instructed them, keep the focus on Caylee. That's where it belongs. Meaning, keep the focus off of me. So, there we have it. On this, the Son of Sam legislation, in order that criminals not be able to profit over their crimes through TV and books and movie rights. In Florida, they, according to Nancy Grace, they have, it got reversed by Simon & Schuster, and that's a large publishing house. And you need to know that TV stations and publishing houses are often intermingled. So there, we may have a compromise agenda here. Who knows? Anyway, they reversed it. They changed the law that where the perpetrator cannot profit from his notoriety. Well, if merely of a crime, you know, that would include, would that not include the Anthonys? Even though Nancy Gray said the family is okay, they can make profit. Well, if they have achieved notoriety through the death of their granddaughter, do they not qualify? Now, I don't know the answer to these things, but I do know that the Anthonys, and we all need to keep this in mind, that they have continued to manipulate evidence, to they literally drove off with the crime scene knowingly that the car had held a dead body. And certainly, even if they just suspected it, they're still held responsible for not moving the crime scene or touching it until somebody can determine whether it is a crime scene. Anyway, so of everything that I can think of that is the most painful would be for the Anthonys not to be held accountable for their behavior and to profit from murder that they helped cover up. They were engaged in a cover-up. And excuse me for repeating that, but right now the media is hyperventilating. We don't need to. Those of us who do follow the case and we know the facts that these people were involved in a cover-up, we don't need to be vulnerable to that. So anyway, that was the main thing I wanted to talk about. We are seeing typical psychopathic behavior, you know, the parasite, the person who's sleeping on a couch somewhere, somebody's couch. They're parasites. They don't want to work. They'd rather, you know, like ticks. They are like leeches, like mistletoe. Those are all parasitical organisms. So anyway, I've got 10 minutes here. We'll see whether this thing worked again.